This isn't a story about how two of Hawaii's top high school athletes ended up in Los Angeles. It's not about how the state's best football and volleyball player in 2014 decided to do both at USC. And it's not about how the top offensive guard in the entire country a year later decided to make his way from Kalaipohaku to UCLA. This is a story about how two of the best high school athletes from Hawaii became Rainbow Warriors.
It started like maybe mid-season, you know. I just fell into like a dark place. I kind of lost the love of football. I wasn't really passionate. I knew something was wrong with me.
It's easy to see the allure of a place like UCLA and harder to understand why it isn't for everyone. Fred Ulu-Perry was an all-everything lineman for St. Louis before committing to become a Bruin, a decision he knew had been the wrong one less than a year into his freshman season.
It was SC week, and you know, I wasn't feeling it. I didn't want to play for UCLA anymore, so I just head home.
Three freeways away, SC was where Larry Tuileta ended up. A two-sport star at Punahou, he was the gem of the class of 2014, won over by Trojan lore.
You know, I want to challenge myself, and I want to kind of grow as a person and get out of my comfort zone, because being home with my family and everything, I always have the support of my family, which is never a bad thing. But if you're trying to, you know, want to be on your own and, you know, live your own lifestyle when you get older, I think for me it was best to go away.
The talent in both Tuileta and Ulu-Perry remains undeniable. Playing two sports in college isn't easy. Neither is filling in at every spot on the offensive line. Both are more challenging than accepting a simple truth. Unlocking their full potential was a goal best achieved not in LA, but 2,400 miles to the west.
I think what's cool about life is that, you know, everyone has a different path. You know, if you have that goal in your mind and, you know, you really want to achieve it, I think that, you know, the hard workers and the people that never lose that picture in their mind, they'll achieve it eventually.
Their paths led them back to Hawaii, not because they couldn't have found success, but because they knew where it would mean the most. The path, Ulu-Perry says, should still be walked. He would still have gone away, especially now that he knows the door to greatness in Manoa was still open.
You know, it worked out perfect for me. It was a blessing, and it's a good opportunity for guys to come back home. But I would tell them, get the experience, and if it doesn't work out, you know, there's always home.